देयर इज एक्चुअली 100% रनअप का चांस. दिस स्टॉक कैन ऑल्सो स्टिल रिमेन अ मल्टीबैगर. यहां से यार मार्केट कैप फॉर अ कंपनी लाइक कैन गो 4x 5x ओके बिकॉज दिस इज अ टाइप ऑफ अ मोनोपोली. हाई गाइज, वेलकम टू टूडेज वीडियो. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल. लेट मी डू टू थिंग्स ऑन दिस वीडियो. वन, लेट मी प्रूव वाई इंडियन मार्केट्स विल डबल फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट. बहुत सिंपल डेटा दिखाऊंगा. नंबर टू, लेट मी स्पीक अबाउट सम वेरी सिलेक्टिव momentum stocks, or rather a better way of approaching or explaining that would be a few stocks that are breaking out and which are fundamentally good stocks. Both these points are important, so let me start the story. Number one point, that why is it that the Indian stock markets will double and in what time frame? See, so for that you need to understand two data points. Now recently data came out regarding a company called as BlackRock. Now this is one of the, or rather the biggest asset management company in the world. And agar aap dekhoge that how much AUM, asset under management, does BlackRock manage? It's 10.43 trillion US dollar. Okay, ये US dollar में data है. अब now, Indian mutual fund का आप data देखो. And this data is given in INR terms. This used to be 9.59 trillion rupees in 2014. Now it has gone up to approximately 70 trillion rupees. Now if you want dollar data, just divide this number by 84, because that is how we can convert INR to USD. So to cut the long story short, here is one company where the asset under management is $11 trillion, and here is entire India's mutual fund industry AUM, which is less than $1 trillion. So ye double hoga, definitely hoga, right? And if you are sitting with a huge corpus in 2024, will this double? Yes, it will double. How much time? No one can say. Now, वो एक अलग बात है कि if India's stock market growth might be 15%, the real inflation for you and me, people actually investing in the stock market, might be 14%. But growth आएगी. Okay, so this is like point one, which is very sensible point. Now, how is this an actionable insight for you? See, in 2024, if you're looking at this chart, which is the Nifty 50 chart, you'll see कि यार market कहाँ पे है. Market is like almost like 25, 26 तक पहुँचा था, right? फिर वो गिर के यहाँ पे आ गया 25 पे. So ऐसा कोई major correction तो है नहीं, right? I mean, एक छोटा सा dip आया था. I was active on my member community throughout the entire day, guiding people. So you are actually successfully able to purchase this dip also. The important point is that even if you have a big portfolio right now, cutting it and going away does not make sense. In case you are a long-term investor, at most you should have some cash edge, which I have been proposing. That's A. B, you should be putting that money whenever the opportunity comes. This is again something where I give timely commentary on literally every single day basis. We talk about fundamentals, we talk about market movements, everything on that community. So in case you are a serious investor, definitely do consider it. But the larger point is that even at this stage, you need to be a net investor in the market. Aisa nahi ki aap baithe raho cash pe. An additional point that you need to do is that you need to buy stocks if you are putting in new money in the markets right now, which are in strong momentum, or a better way of explaining it is that which are fundamentally good stocks, which have started to give a breakout, which are in good industry, good stocks, good fundamentals, everything good. And valuation wise, they are not like crazy. Okay, so these are some of the stocks that I will be speaking about next. But I hope that the first pillar was clear ki bhai nikalna kyun nahi hai, kyunki jo aapka AUM hai of the entire mutual fund industry, jo SIP badhti chali ja rahi hai, wo jayegi kahan, right? Wo jana to eventually stock market mein hi hai. There are limited set of investment options in India. Stock market is one such investment. So if you step back, look at the macro view, this is the macro view that you should believe in. This will give you the confidence to invest. So with that said, let us start speaking about individual stocks that are rebounding, which are good stocks in my understanding, and I'll give you an analysis on three specific points. One is industry overview dunga us cheez ka bahut quick, right? And second key thing, I will give you strength and weakness of that particular stock. And third and finally, I will speak about valuation. That valuation pe kahan pe hai, right? I mean, is it like an overvalued category, fairly valued? You could still consider it or not. Please watch this video till the very end. Aise aadha dura dekh ke mat jana, right? Now, these are my viewpoints. This is not an investment advice ki aap jaake kar do and all that stuff. No, I'm just giving you my viewpoint. You listen to contrary opinions and reach whatever conclusion you like, okay? So, okay, so let's begin. And the first key stock that I will speak about is called as SW Solar. Abhi stock ne bahut dhamal machaya hai, right? In the sense ki bahut bada badh bhi gaya and then it fell also. So let me give you analysis on three points, right? So number one, let me speak about the industry first and where this stock is placed in this industry and can this industry even grow from this point or not, right? So number one, SW Solar jo hai, this is an EPC within the solar industry. Now, uska matlab kya hota hai? EPC within the solar industry. Bahut simple sa meaning hai. For example, jaise solar panels wagera jo lagte hain, एंड उसके अराउंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर का काम होता है, राइट, कि सोलर पैनल लगने हैं, उसमें माउंटिंग होनी है, दुनिया भर की चीज़ें होनी है, राइट, विद दैट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्रिएशन. नाउ ईपीसी मींस इंजीनियरिंग प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन. ओके, सो एसडब्ल्यू सोलर प्रोवाइड्स ईपीसी टू अदर कंपनीज दैट आर बिल्डिंग दिस सोलर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. नाउ एक तो काम हो गया इसमें ईपीसी बनाने का पूरा, राइट. सेकेंड पार्ट हो गया मेंटेनेंस. ओके, नाउ इफ यू स्टेप बैक एंड अंडरस्टैंड द इंडस्ट्री, नाउ इज दिस अ ग्रोइंग इंडस्ट्री, श्रिंकिंग इंडस्ट्री? नाउ सी व्हाट आई विल से हियर इज दैट वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स क्लीनर सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी, राइट. एंड एसडब्ल्यू सोलर इज अ स्मॉल मार्केट कैप कंपनी, राइट, ऐसा कोई बहुत ज्यादा है नहीं, राइट. कैन इट डबल ट्रिपल, राइट, कैन इट गो 2x 3x मार्केट कैप? डेफिनेटली इट कैन गो, राइट. नाउ Whenever a small cap company grows to a mid cap to a large cap company, the industry needs to be in that growth phase. Okay, so is solar a growth phase industry? Yes. Now, can government come and eat share of private players in this industry? No. अब इसमें बहुत सारे points analyze करने, I'll not bore you with that. But the larger point I want to tell you is that solar EPC space in India, that is gaining traction, it is getting built. It's not as if that this company cannot grow. Now, is this the recommendation to buy? No. Okay, baki cheeze sun lena. Now, second point aata hai, the strength and weakness of the company. Now, ek pura video ban sakta hai, but let me just quickly explain the salient points. So, for example, promoter pe aap jaoge, aapko dekhega Reliance New Energy Limited, right? So, Reliance ki bhagidari is like 33% almost, right? So, it owns 1/3 of SW Solar, a small cap company. Ab bhai maintenance contract milne hai, toh who will get it, right? Reliance ki Akshay Srivastava, right? So, of course, Reliance aise bade-bade khiladi में मिलेगा. सो द पॉइंट इज दैट दिस इज द मोट ऑफ द कंपनी, राइट. लोग दुनिया भर की बातें करते रहते हैं कि ये मोट वो मोट, नो भाई, जुगाड़ से मिलती है ईपीसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ. दिस इज अ मैसिव मोट, बिडिंग होती है इन सब चीजों में. सो दिस इज द कंपेटिटिव एडवांटेज ऑफ द फर्म. Now, what is the risk? The risk is that because Reliance is the lead player on this particular company, Reliance is a conglomerate. Unki duniya bhar ki company hai. Now, Reliance, aisa nahi hota ki pure ka pura Reliance is going up, right? Reliance is also going up, Jio is also going up, and you know, SW Solar is also going up. Fir toh, oh, no. So, management is done of all these stock prices in a way, right? I'm not saying manipulation, I'm saying management is done. Aisa nahi hota ki all Reliance listed stocks will go up in like one go only and hit like all-time highs. So, cut the long story short, अब होगा क्या कि काफी टाइम तक रिलायंस को रोक के रखा जा सकता है, राइट. उस समय जियो चल पड़ेगा, देन मे बी लाइक यू नो सम अदर कंपनी माइट बी स्टॉप्ड फॉर अ वाइल, राइट. फिर उसके बाद कुछ और चल पड़ेगा. व्हाई? बिकॉज आप देख सकते हो कि ये जितने भी लोग हैं, राइट, FIIs, DIIs, these strongholds, right, or strong hands, they actually invest in certain type of Reliance Group companies, not all of them. Now, this is a risk because this has broader corporate exposure, so which is both an advantage and disadvantage. Now, how has the company done? Well, if you take a look, the numbers are shrinking, right? So, for example, yahan pe aap dekhoge loss widening kam ho rahi hai. Now, Reliance, because it has entered this stock from 2021 onwards, right? So, hume itne darne ki zarurat nahi hai, right? They will figure out the situation. That is the hope that everyone or every investor in SW Solar has. Kyunki jab naye contract milenge, then it will reflect in like sales figure and net profit figures, all that stuff, right? Now, let me quickly speak about the valuation perspective of the stock also. So, for example, now if you take a look, so in the last 1 year, the stock price had doubled. Now it has corrected. Then it might consolidate in a new range and then it might give a breakout. So, this is a good stock to buy on consolidation. Whenever you see consolidation happening on this stock, you could consider aggregating it if you believe in the narrative. और भी ज्यादा पॉइंट्स हैं, बट आई विल अगेन नॉट बिलीवर. आई विल मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्टॉक, बट आई होप दैट दिस गेव यू अ फेयर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द स्टॉक. नाउ द सेकंड स्टॉक विच इज इन अ काइंड ऑफ अ मोमेंटम इज बंधन बैंक, राइट. नाउ बंधन बैंक में बहुत सारी प्रॉब्लम्स चली थी, राइट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जो उनके सीईओ थे उन्होंने रिजाइन करा, दुनिया भर की प्रॉब्लम चलती रही थी. आफ्टर मेकिंग इट्स हाई समवेयर हियर, राइट, इन 2020 इट हैज बीन ऑन अ डाउनवर्ड स्लोपिंग ट्रैजेक्टरी. दिस इज द नेगेटिव पार्ट. लेकिन अब पॉजिटिव पार्ट ये है कि अगर इसका कंसोलिडेशन हो गया खत्म, राइट, इस जोन में, इफ द स्टॉक हैज ऑलरेडी बीन कंसोलिडेटेड, देन जब वो बढ़ेगा तो इट कैन रन अप क्वाइट अ बिट. इन फैक्ट दिस हैज बीन बैक्ड बाय नंबर्स ऑल्सो. मैं आपको एक बार इसके नंबर्स दिखा देता हूँ. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप देख सकते हो 2021 में वॉट वॉज द बिजनेस, जब आपने ऑल टाइम हाई पता, द बिजनेस वॉज 12,000 करोड़ का रेवेन्यू था. अब कितना है? 19,000 करोड़. हैव द प्रॉफिट्स डिप्ड? एब्सोल्युटली नॉट. प्रॉफिट्स हैव एक्चुअली गॉन अप. So you are getting a stock at like a 4-5 year correction, not at the same price, but at a discounted price. So this is point one. And this is the good part. Now, ab baat kar lete industry ki thodi. So in what type of an industry is Bandhan Bank in? Well, it is into risky lending business, right? Now, is risky lending business dangerous? Yes, of course, because NPA ki problem ho jati hai. Now, NPA ki problem kab hoti hai? Well, NPA ki problem hoti hai when the loans are to be collected. Now, hua kya hai in the last few years that the interest rates have been really, really high. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल मान के चलो कि इंटरेस्ट रेट्स इन इंडिया जो अभी इंटरेस्ट साइकिल है वो पीक पे है, राइट? सो पीक पे मान के चलो कि अगर रिस्की लोन्स पीपल आर बोरोइंग एट लाइक से 12%, ओके, नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी हाई रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट टू पे, राइट? एंड अभी भी ऐसे लोन्स की फाइनेंसिंग हो रही है, तभी तो ये रेवेन्यू दिख रहा है, राइट? सो दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट आई वॉन्ट टू ड्राइव होम इज दैट सी देर विल ऑलवेज बी अ डिमांड ऑफ रिस्की लोन्स इन अ क्रेडिट डेफिसिट कंट्री लाइक इंडिया. दिस इज नॉट गोइंग अवे. नॉट एवरी वन हैज एक्सेस टू HDFC बैंक एंड कोटेक बैंक जिनसे जाके वो लोन ले लेते हैं. यू हैव टू टेक लोन्स और सम सेगमेंट ऑफ आर सोसाइटी नीड्स टू टेक लोन फ्रॉम बंधन बैंक एट दिस रेट, ओके? सो देयर NPA प्रॉब्लम विल ऑलवेज बी देयर. इंडस्ट्री से सेकंड रिलेटेड पॉइंट आता है कि वी हैव टू अप्लाई आर ब्रेन इन टर्म्स ऑफ फिगरिंग आउट ये NPA प्रॉब्लम कब आएगी और, ओके? नाउ उसके लिए मैं आपको इंटरेस्ट रेट की कहानी बता रहा था कि देखो अभी तो बहुत हैवी लोन्स फाइनेंस हो चुके हैं, राइट? एंड नाउ अब इसमें कलेक्शन कब आता है. नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ दीज लोन्स मैच्योर विद इन अ 2 to 5 year विंडो, ओके? सो तब रीपेमेंट होती है. सो अभी तो पीक साइकिल बन चुकी है, राइट? इन 2024-2023 ऑल्सो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स वर हाई. नाउ इसके रेपरकशंस देखेंगे अकॉर्डिंग टू माई एनालिसिस 2026 ऑनवर्ड्स, बट टिल देन देर कुड बी अ रीबाउंड ऑन द स्टॉक. दैट इज माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑन इट. वाई? बिकॉज विच ब्रिंग्स अस टू द थर्ड पॉइंट विच इज द वैल्यूएशन ऑफ द स्टॉक. मैंने आपको अभी बताई चीज कि फ्रॉम अ वैल्यूएशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू द स्टॉक हैज कंसोलिडेटेड फॉर द लास्ट 4 years अप्रॉक्सिमेटली एंड द टाइप ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस द कंपनी हैज गिवन दैट इज गुड इनफ. इट हैज ऑलरेडी गॉन थ्रू ट्रबल्स, राइट, इन टर्म्स ऑफ आउटस्टर ऑफ द CEO एंड बंच ऑफ अदर डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स. सो नेट नेट द कंपनी लुक्स गुड फ्रॉम दैट एंगल. एक बार इन्वेस्टर होल्डिंग भी देख लेते हैं. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप देखोगे कि FII, DII और प्रमोटर्स की होल्डिंग मिला लो, दिस हैज नेट गॉन अप इन द लास्ट 2 years. सो ओवरऑल इट लुक्स सॉलिड. देयर इज अ हाई चांस ऑफ रीबाउंड. अब आप बोलोगे कि यार ऐसा स्टॉक बता दो विच कैन डबल, राइट, एंड नो रिस्क हो उसमें. ऐसा हो नहीं सकता, राइट? दैट इज वेरी कॉमन सेंसिकल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इफ द मार्केट इज एट एन ऑल टाइम हाई देर विल बी रिस्क ऑन द स्टॉक्स. बट इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉर अ लो रिस्क ऑप्शन आई वुड स्टिल लुक एट समथिंग लाइक HDFC एंड कोटेक बैंक. Is there something wrong with HDFC and Kotak Bank? Absolutely not. The numbers are amazing. I keep on speaking it, but I have been speaking about it for the last 1-1.5 years. I am maxed out. I have already built my position. I have not cut anything. Wo, in fact, bad bhi gaya. In the last few months, HDFC Bank, Kotak Bank have given a little bit of run-up also, but not anywhere close to what they should be giving. Okay? So this becomes a low-risk proposition. Iska bhi main aapko 2 minute mein analysis kar deta hun. See, unlike Bandhan Bank, Kotak and HDFC banks are solid because their NPA is typically low because the type of customers they lend out money to. Most of their customers are white collared customers, so inme koi major default ke chances kam hai, right? These are low risk banks, possibly the lowest risk banks, because inke corporate loan exposure is also very well managed, right? So let's put it this way, because jab PSU mein loan crisis hoti hai aur PSU mein jab NPA crisis hoti hai more specifically, tab the reason why that crisis happens is because these PSUs are lending out to some big corporate, okay, and that corporate does some ghaplebazi. So you already know the story, so I'll not bore you with that. But if you look at HDFC Kotak type of banks right now, the industry is solid because unka NPA kam rahega, right? Now unless of course something goes off with the economy itself, right? So this is point one. सेकेंड पॉइंट आता है कि स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ HDFC बैंक कोटेक. यार देखो नेट नेट HDFC बैंक, कोटेक बैंक, एक्सिस, ICICI, ऑल दीज बैंक्स आर सिमिलर. इट्स नॉट एज इफ कि एक कोई बहुत ही धमाल काम कर रहा है, एक नहीं कर रहा है. लोग मर्जर करते रहते हैं कि HDFC का मर्जर हो गया इसलिए द स्टॉक पर, इट्स लाइक यूजलेस डिस्कशन. द रीजन इज कि भाई अच्छा चलो HDFC का मर्जर हो गया, व्हाई डिड कोटेक स्टॉप गिविंग रन अप? ओके, इट डज नॉट मेक एनी सेंस. बोथ आर बिहेविंग इन अ वेरी सिमिलर मैनर. नाउ लेट मी जस्ट क्विकली डू लाइक वन फाइनल पॉइंट. सो कोटेक को देख लेते हैं, राइट? सो यहाँ पे मैं आपको कोटेक दिखा देता हूँ. तो यहाँ पे आप देखोगे द परफॉर्मेंस हैज बीन अमेजिंग, राइट? आई मीन परफॉर्मिंग, दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट परफॉर्मिंग सेक्टर्स. दिस इज एन अंडर वैल्यूड बेट स्टिल एंड पॉसिबली दी ओनली अंडर वैल्यूड बेट लेफ्ट एज पर माई एनालिसिस. Numbers have almost 2.5 times, right? So 2.5 times growth ho chuki hai profit numbers ki. So this is that good a performance. Valuation final baat kar lete hain fatafat, right? So uspe bhi main zyada nahi bolunga aapse ki 2021 se aap dekho, it has exact same range, nothing changed. But 2021 se profits ho gaya 2.5 times, revenues ho gaya almost 3 times, okay? So jitni price yahan pe honi chahiye thi, there is actually a 100% run up ka chance. Many people might be laughing at me right now. Now we will meet again once these banks actually give a 100% run up. But fundamentally speaking, I don't see a chance of less than 20% CAGR at least for the next 2 to 3 years if the economy does okay, right? So this is the bottom line on these stocks. Now one stock that I'm looking closely into, and maisme kal I will write a community member post also in detail, and this sector I'm bullish. So it's healthcare, diagnostic, hospital sector. So this is an area again in the next 10 years yes, a lot of multi-baggers can be created from this industry. There was a lot of interest during the 2020-2021 phase when COVID was there. They are for diagnostic business, Dr. Reddy's, all this. इन्हें बहुत रन अप दिया था एंड फिर यू नो उसके बाद बहुत करेक्शन में चले गए थे राइट सो आई फील दैट नाउ इज द राइट टाइम टू एक्चुअली री लुक एट दीज कंपनीज एंड आई एम लुकिंग एट डॉक्टर रेडीज क्लोजली राइट एंड आई फील दैट देर इज अ गुड चांस दैट अगेन दिस स्टॉक माइट गिव अ गुड रन अप नाउ व्हाई एम आई बुलिश ऑन डॉक्टर रेडी सो एक बार मैं आपको फंडामेंटल डेटा दिखा देता हूँ सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल जो लेटेस्ट नंबर आए हैं इन द लास्ट टू ईयर्स यू कैन सी द प्रॉफिट ओवरऑल राइजिंग दिस इज अ वेरी हेल्दी साइन राइट Actually, there was no issue in Dr. Reddy type of business. The issue was that its revenues grew really fast, right, during COVID. And everyone was sentimentally very driven in terms of owning like hospital stocks, pharma companies, testing laboratories, and all these stocks. Now, अब क्या हो गया कि there is a massive consolidation that has happened. For example, you will see, and मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ यहाँ से, जैसे for example, 2019 में it was at 27, फिर doubling हो गई stock price की बहुत जल्दी, okay? फिर this was approximately 5500 by 2021, right? So last 3 years में क्या हुआ है? कुछ नहीं हुआ है, right? I mean, it's not as if that this has been a massive price rise. So now it looks like that this is going to be a decent 15-20% CAGR type of safer stock. Which is actually translating into good profits. So industry is good. This is a much needed industry. The stock seems to be okay. The PE does not seems to be much overvalued from that angle. So I would be aggregating it. In fact, I wanted to aggregate something like Glenmark Pharma also. Phir lekin yahan pe kya hua ki this is just not coming down only, right? It has just gone up like crazy, right? And I might buy it. If I get it at a discount, otherwise I will leave it given the market circumstances right now. But Dr. Reddy's look okay from that angle. I'll add 1-2 more just to hedge that Dr. Reddy's bucket. But this is a good bucket to analyze and kind of build your investments in for the next phase of growth and strong momentum can come on this. Okay, so final stock that I will speak about is CAMS, right? And CAMS was already in my portfolio. Uspe kaafi achha profit hua bhi hai, right? And I'm not selling it yet, right? Why? Because see, this is a type of a mid-cap company. Aap isko ab like, you know, market cap ki ab definition change hona chahiye mid-cap small cap ki because so much money has come into the market. But anyways, the bottom line is that see, yahan se yaar market cap for a company like CAMS can go 4x, 5x, okay? Because this is a type of a monopoly. It's not as if that they are facing a lot of competition. Industry is needed. For example, jahan se humne kahani shuru kari thi ki, okay, AUM of India's mutual fund industry can go 3x. Now, if AUM of mutual fund industry is going 3x, then what else will 3x along with it? Okay, something like CAMS, CDSL, something like broking companies. Now, these are major money churners. From industry point of view, no issues. What about stock point of view? Something like CAMS. No issues, right? The numbers have been good. There is no issue. So, फटाफट मैं वो भी बता देता हूँ आपको. तो आप देख सकते हो कि यार ठीक है, decent growth है, right? It's not as if it's like, you know, crazy growth, but this is more than 20-25% CAGR growth, which is very good, right? If you're looking for a low risk type of a stock. And what about valuation? So valuation भी अगर हम देख लें तो ऐसा नहीं है कि यार एकदम मतलब बहुत you know crazy तरीके से growth हो गई. आप ये पूरा arc बनते हुए देख सकते हो, right? So this is consolidation, right? So it will happen something like this. So this is like consolidation and breakout. कोई ऐसा खास real breakout हुआ नहीं है, right? So if you are looking on a 3-year, 4-year basis, this is not breakout that we can say. Stock has given growth. In fact, मेरे portfolio में it is like given more than 100% run up, okay? But it is not as if of this Glen Pharma. So I believe that this stock can also still remain a multi-bagger if you are holding it for like 5-year, 6-year period. This is a good stock to own from that angle, which is kind of low risk as of now. Okay. So I hope that you enjoyed this conversation. It gave you some clarity. Tomorrow, I'm going to do more posts on the member community discussing more of these stocks where momentum can come. So there is a list of 15-20 stocks that I will prepare, post it on my community. So in case you are a serious learner, definitely do consider joining it. And I will see you soon. So till there, take care and thank you so much for watching.